Because I don't need to do an extra, I don't tell you. That's why it's naturally within you. Within me? Oh, come on, teacher. So that don't worry. Even though donkey is a brainless animal, it could be a symbol of victory for you one day. What? How come? Good example is your dad. Since then, all my colleagues call me by that stupid animal's name. I can remember when I was very small, sometimes my mom used to call my dad by that prestigious name. Coincidentally, my grandfather's name is Jack, was well known in the village as Jackass. So grandfather, father, and the son, the legacy continues. When I look at the behavior of my son, I'm sure the legacy will continue for 4 years. My dear friends, I was branded as a fool in the school. But you know, about 3 years I became the most outstanding student of the school. Because most of the time, I was standing outside the classroom for not doing homework. The principal summoned my parents to the school and said, Mr. Fernando, your son is always late to school and scored very low marks in the term test. It seems he's not using his brain at all. My mother whispered to my father, no wonder just like the father. My father looked at me with anger and said, hey, donkey, you better explain the principal. Donkey, how does he know my other name? Ah, that day, drama teacher told me. Then I started explaining. Principal, sir, can you remember that day you said to become successful, you need to walk the extra mile and think differently? I was so pumped up with those inspirational words and started working on it. As a result, I found an additional path, sir, where it is 1 mile more than the usual distance from my home to school. Every day I came late to school, sir, as a result of walking that extra mile. I saw the disgusted face of my mother. Again, she whispered, oh, I have to look after 2 donkeys now. I continue. As you very well know, sir, I'm a very obedient student of you, know. That is why I followed your rule number 1, extra mile. I knew that is itself is not sufficient to become a successful man. Therefore, I decided to follow your rule number 2 as well, think differently. When the term tests were on, all my colleagues studied before the exam. Thinking differently, I studied after the exam. So tell me, sir, who's responsible for all these issues? Is it you or me? He was so annoyed. Hey, are you the donkey or am I? Fighting. Both. He was so annoyed. Mr. Fernando, your son is already acting like a donkey. Before becoming a buffalo, you better show him your side credit. Friends, when I grew up, I really wanted to come out of donkey syndrome. Unfortunately, there was no one at home to help me because of the same genetical background. On the first day of my first job, the chairman was addressing the staff. And he said a very powerful exhortation. If you really get into my shoes, you will realize the gravity of running a business. At the conclusion of the speech, I just jumped and asked, excuse me, sir, can I borrow your chair? The all staff members were stunned. Did I say anything foolish? Staff members were stunned. Then chairman spoke. Well done, young man. We need jokers like you at the office to keep our lives moving. Well done, keep it up. Everybody started applauding. No one knew my background. Since then, I became a humorist among the colleagues in my office. There was a beautiful girl who loved my humor. As a result, she married me, thinking I'm a talented humorist. On the first day of the honeymoon itself, she realized I'm not a humorist, but an utter fool. I won't ask what and how. But She used my natural foolish talkativeness to create beautiful, hilarious stories for me. As a result, today I'm standing in front of you as a human speaker. Friends, don't let your weakness dominate you. Always make use of it as an inspiration of victory. President Barack Obama won 2 presidential elections with this symbol. This is party symbol. Literally, this is party symbol. From sitcoms or donkey. Who knows the same symbol will bring victory? Tell me, what is the theme?